So in this video I'm going to show you how to do a dedicated Wreckfest server, whether it's you want a dedicated one or just one to for you and your friends to play on privately. I'll be doing this the Steam CMD way. But if you don't want to do it this way, you can go to your games list on Steam, and at the top I think there's a drop down menu and it says tools. Tick that box. And then where you see Wreckfest, you should see underneath it Wreckfest Dedicated Server. But we're going to do it this way because some of us are probably installing this on a remote computer, so it runs better and we can actually play the game properly. So this way you don't need a Steam account, you don't need to log in or any details like that. You can basically download the server files for free. So the first thing we need to do is we need to search for Steam CMD. And then we need to go to Steam CMD Valve Developer Community. I'll put the link in the description. I'll put the link to this page, not to the actual download, because that I think they changed it, I don't know. So you want here, download Steam CMD for Windows, and the actual link to download it is right here. So you download it, it takes a second. I'll just put that up. We'll just leave it there. In fact, we'll just close. Yeah, we'll just bring this out here. And we'll line that down. And first you need to create a folder. Let's call it Steam CMD. Open this. And if you need something to open it with, look for WinRAR, R-A-R, WinRAR. It is free. You get a pop-up that annoys you. But surely in Windows 10, I think there's a default WinRAR that'll open this anyway. So you want to drag Steam CMD, excuse me, into Steam CMD folder you just made. And then you want to close this. We can get rid of that. You'll probably need it later, but who knows. Open this, run this, line that down, let that do its thing. And we actually need the ID for the game. So we need Wreckfest Steam ID, so search for that, and as you can see it's there. You can click on it if you want to get more info, but we just need this here. We need to copy the, oh actually totally wrong, we actually need dedicated server, my mistake. Dedicated server Steam ID, press enter, and we can click this if you want, and as you can see there it is, click copy. Every game and every server files has got an app ID, so make sure you actually type the actual game and dedicated server after it, otherwise you're not going to get the right one. You'll actually download the game instead, which it won't do because you're not logged in. Right, where's my little notepad? So that will from a different game, so paste that there. I'll save that then, I don't lose it. Right, this should have done by now. Yep. So this is all set and done. So we want to copy this. I'll put it in the description so you can copy it or just type it, whatever you want. Want to paste it. Log in. Once that's all done, we want to copy this, or you can type it, whichever you want. I'll put it in the description again. And then I want to paste that here. And then it'll start installing and downloading the game. And then after that, you just wait until it's done. As you can see, once you install that Steam CMD in the folder, it will create the normal Steam files, like Steam actually installed itself, but the actual data is in the normal place, Steam apps, common, and it's under Wreckfest server. It's still downloading, so it's not there yet, so we'll just wait there.
A few moments later.
And we're at 99%. We'll verify it, shouldn't take long. 25%, should jump to 80%, it's just reading the files now, already at 50%. So let's go in here, has it done it yet? Nope, he's not transferred the files over yet. We're at 75%, we're at 81. Come on, 100. Committing, I think that's moving the files over. Yep, moving the files over. 92%, fully installed. So now that's done, you can press the X and it'll automatically log out and close itself down. And then we can play in here. So remember, this folder we made, you want to go in apps, common, and then there's your server. So we'll just cover that up a bit. Right then. So in order for you to get the config file, let me just look at this a minute. The actual config file's there. But what we'll do is we'll start the server to get all the files, because I think some files are missing here. So what you want to do is double click start server. There we go, the server config file is there. It's just installing the files to run it. Your firewall will pop up and say allow, so just say allow to that. Like public networks and stuff like that. This is so your friends can actually play on it. You can click allow. And it'll also connect to Steam as well. You need to allow it for that. There's also lots of options in the list, command list here to set stuff. There's actually a god mode, your game modes and stuff like that. Right, so now that's done, I think that's done. We want to press X on this. So once that's all done, you can go ahead and go and edit the settings. So you go to server config, and here you see, let's see, we have server name. Obviously I've changed this to manifest. You've got your welcome message, and you've got your password, and you've got your max player settings. Now, these are the global settings for you to change and do it normal. And then this section here sets the points. So if you get 25th place and you're winner, you get less points position forever. So you need to grab, like, I set it up to 16th place. You need to grab this, click copy, and put this here. Oops. So remember, it's the first bit before the equal sign that you put in here, and I save that. Same settings for that, grid order and stuff like that. You can change that to random, random, that's good. Or you can do it by the person who gets the most points and stuff like that. Weather, I always have that on random. And you've got other options here for you to browse through and take a look at. So let's go back to the bottom and do the important thing. Right, this bit here has these in front of it, which means they're not going to work. So get rid of them, apart from the top one, because that's the actual first event loop. And then what you want to do is you want to copy this one and put it in the first one here like I have. And then you want to copy this and then go to the second loop and just, it'll be like this basically, just delete what's ever under here and then paste it here like this. And then what you need to do is LAD is the map. As you can see, for the first event loop, I've put the map loop, which is in here somewhere. There's a map called loop. So for my second map, I want Demolition Arena. So I'm going to copy that. And also I'll post this list in the description so you can actually read it. So for the second loop, I want... Why have they done that? I want that map. And then for the third loop, I want this map. So basically you can put all your favourite maps on and it'll loop through as you race. And all your players will probably stay and play with you, or your friends will be happy. Make sure if you do that there's no spaces on the end. I don't even know what that was. Let's delete it. That was our one. And then you click save. And all the map names with the pictures here. Different variations are in the middle here. And you've got all the whatever that means at the side. I don't know, is there a table? Yeah, weather IDs at the side. It tells you which weather works with it. And then you've got the ID, and then you've got the actual event name in-game. And of course, the pictures. And there's the loop. That one's easy to remember. There is another list, but there's no pictures, and I think it's a direct list. So I'll show you them here. There is 102 maps, so go nuts, put them all in if you want. But there is guides on how to install these maps, and there's more instructions here to help you with that. And you can actually just remove this command line if you don't want weather. Weather should be random, so you might want to fix that before you start it. Right, so let's start it up and see what the difference is this time. I think the first loop had three bots on. There you go. There's the three bots. As you can see, Wreckfest Dedicated server starts in no time. You've got other commands up here you can type to add yourself as an admin and stuff like that. You can also do it in game. I think, let's have a look, where is the admin thing? Because I mean, you're gonna, there it is. When enabled, admin starts to serve. No, we don't want that one. Is there any more? There we go. Just add your Steam ID in here. Get rid of that number, put your Steam ID in, and it'll make you an admin. If you want a moderator, I think it's that one. I'm not sure. You put the Steam IDs in that one for moderators. And if you want to make someone a temporary moderator, you can actually do that in-game. And when the server restarts or has done a full map rotation, it takes them off moderator. So anyway, I hope that's not confused you. And let me know in the comments if you need any more help or anything like that. See you later. Bye-bye.